Look now from our exclusive Salesforce Tower cam, looking out at Alcatraz after a gorgeous, warm, and sunny day. Perfect for a little swimming or biking or running.
Or all three. KPIX John Ramos says thousands did just that in the Escape from Alcatraz Triathlon.
This morning, 2,000 people did what was once thought to be impossible.
It's a daunting swim. I mean, you're out and at the rock, where supposedly no prisoner could ever escape.
Each year, the Escape from Alcatraz Triathlon shows how silly that notion was, because after the 1.5-mile swim, competitors hustle in and saddle up for an 18-mile bike ride. They then finish off the morning with a grueling 8-mile run that features the dreaded sand ladder, a steep climb from Baker Beach where each step is pure agony. It's the kind of challenge that makes this such a prized title among professionals, like Ben Canute, who won for the second straight year.
It feels like you're trying to escape from jail a little bit. You're up and down and all around, so it's just, yeah, it's an incredible race.
Sarah Haskins won the women's division back in 2014, but had to take last year off to have her second child. And that's why it meant so much when she crossed the finish line today.
It's one of the biggest races in the country, so to come away with a win here is, I'm really proud of the accomplishment.
But most who compete here are not pros, just average people who take on an extraordinary challenge. Madeline Dorling was already proud to see her mom compete, but when this contestant with only one leg ran by, her mind was officially blown.
I was thinking, like, holy crap, I couldn't even do that if I even had both legs. He's amazing.
And Laura Davidson and most of her family were in the perfect spot to see her cousin Christina finish one of the world's toughest triathlons.
Swimming with the sharks in 56-degree temperature water out there, that's insane to me, but they love it. They feed off the insanity, I think.
It used to be considered insanity to try to escape from Alcatraz prison. Now every year, 2,000 people do it for fun. In San Francisco, John Ramos, KPIX 5.
Competitors for Escape from Alcatraz used to be chosen in a lottery, but starting this year, they had to qualify in a series of races in Huntington Beach, Philadelphia, D.C., London, and Beijing.